Hey everyone, I'm going to talk about statins, those drugs that we use for cholesterol, and I'm going to be more specific. I'm going to talk about the adverse effect when the patient takes grapefruit juice, all right? So normally, statins, they are in the blood. When we take the drug, the drug goes to the plasma, and then it goes to the liver. In the liver, there is a group of enzymes that are going to what? To metabolize the drug, and then we're gonna have the therapeutic effect. That's what happens normally. When the patient takes grapefruit juice, the grapefruit juice is going to block the enzyme. By blocking the enzymes, what happens? The statins cannot be metabolized. Because it's not metabolized, then it's going to be increasing the plasma. And then what happens next? It's going into the muscle fibers. Muscle fibers, they have a myoglobin, which is a protein inside the muscles. So if the statin is increasing the blood, then these muscle fibers will be destroyed. That's what we call rhabdomyolysis. Rhabdo, skeletal, myo, muscle, and lysis means rupture. So that's the reason the patient feels what? The patient will feel pain, muscular pain. So that's why, because of the destruction of the muscles, patient feels pain, but at the same time, then we're gonna have what? Too much myoglobin now leaking into the bloodstream. If you destroy the fiber, the protein is going to leak out. Now we're gonna have hypermyoglobinemia, an excess of myoglobin in the blood. And if we have hypermyoglobinemia, which is this one, hypermyoglobinemia, then the kidney is gonna try to remove the excess of myoglobin in the blood. That's the reason now this myoglobinemia, which is excessively increased in the blood, is gonna be eliminated through the kidneys. And that's why the patient will have now what? It's gonna have myoglobinuria. Basically, the myoglobin is gonna be present in the urine because the kidneys are trying to remove that myoglobin. That's why the patient will describe the urine as dark urine. It looks like Coke, like soda, right? So that's a sign that tells you that the patient is having the signs and symptoms of rhabdomyolysis. Caused by what? By the grapefruit juice that the patient is taking. So that's the reason. Now you understand the reason why the patient has rhabdomyolysis. You know, if he has rhabdomyolysis, the disruption of the muscle, then it's gonna have what? Muscle pain. Because of the muscle pain, the patient also is gonna have what? An excess of myoglobin in the blood, which is called hypermyoglobinemia, because of the destruction of the muscle fibers. Now, myoglobin goes into the bloodstream, increases there, kidney is trying to remove the excess of the myoglobin, and then that's why dark urine. You see? Basically, those are the signs and symptoms of toxicity with statin caused by what? Grapefruit juice. That's the reason you guys need to teach your patients about not to take grapefruit juice, and also teach them about signs and symptoms of statin toxicity. So this way they can contact the healthcare providers, and that's the kind of questions that you see in those question banks out there for your NCLEX exam. So that's the reason you need to make sure you understand all these signs and symptoms. And now it makes sense to you, because you know where everything comes from, all right? So this is the way we're gonna be breaking things down for you for pharmacology in the crash course that is coming on the June 5th. That is gonna be 3 days talking about drugs, only farm, for you to be able to understand, not to memorize, adverse effects, action of the drugs, and how we have to take care of the patients when it comes to the therapy, okay? So take care, have a good one, and for me, it was a pleasure. Bye.